Let's talk about the interviews now. So you've sent out your invites. You've gotten people who have agreed to come. And you said you do Skype interviews. Do you do also in-person interviews?
Absolutely.
So let's talk about the Skype interviews first.
Sure.
For a single applicant, how many Skype interviews would they do?
Just one.
Just one. Mm-hmm. And does that help decide whether they move on to an in-person interview?
Absolutely.
And what is the interviewer looking for in the Skype interview?
Well, by that time, we've already reviewed the application, so we have a sense of their academic performance. And so, although we focus a little bit on the academic skills of the applicant, we spend most of the time looking at the interpersonal interactions and the person's knowledge of our program and their engagement with us as we interview them on Skype. The whole interview lasts 20 minutes.
How do you judge their knowledge of your program?
Well, based on the questions that they ask, are they informed questions or are they generic questions that they may ask of any program?
Mm-hmm. And so now you've screened out the people who just applied and didn't look up your program.
Yeah.
And they have some ability to communicate, mm-hmm. and you've invited them for the in-person mm-hmm. interview. When does the interview process really start?
You mean with the person
yeah.
or in?
For the person, from the person's point of view.
Well, the interview process has begun as soon as we do the Skype process. Mm-hmm. So now, any communication that happens between the applicant and the program is part of the interview process. I always caution my applicants and my advisees that it's really important how you treat the residency coordinator, anybody who's with the program or the hospital. If it's not a good interaction, we usually don't rank the applicant. Mm-hmm. And then the process proceeds with coming in for that live interview, meeting with three different people. Usually it's two faculty and a resident. Mm-hmm. They get a tour of the hospital, tour of the clinic, and then we wrap it up.
Mm-hmm. And I want to expand on that a little more. So they get a tour.
Yes.
Who's giving the tour, and does that person feedback information to the process?
Absolutely everybody is engaged in the interview process. We give a lot of thought to how we structure our day, and anybody that gives us feedback is very, very important for us because we want this person to thrive in our setting. And so we want them to be able to feel comfortable and to engage positively with our staff, with our residents, with our faculty. And so if anybody has an alarming encounter and gives us that feedback, we will usually not rank that applicant.
Mm-hmm. So you mentioned that when the applicant asks good questions about your program, informed questions,
yes.
that's good. What are other things that you would consider good questions?
I think it's always good to ask about the financial security of the institution and the future vision of the program director for the program, so that you know that the program's heading in the right direction and in a direction that's aligned with the applicant's future. It's always great to have a conversation about the relationship between residents themselves and residents and faculty.
What about bad questions?
The bad questions are the canned questions, you know, things that are already on my website. When people ask me things that are very clear on the website, I get a little bit disappointed, mm-hmm. and I may not be so intrigued by the applicant.
Mm-hmm. What about an applicant who asks about salary and vacation time? What's your reaction to that?
It's usually not a question that's appropriate for a program director. That information is to be found on the website. And most of our applicants save those questions for our residents. Mm-hmm. And usually it's one-on-one with a resident. There are also several opportunities to engage with residents after the interview. And so some of those questions may be better asked later in a different mm-hmm. context.
Mm-hmm. So we've talked about what the applicant asks. What do you ask the applicant?
We've actually developed behavioral interview questions, which I unfortunately can't share with you because then I would have to create a whole new set of questions. But we ask very simple questions. They're not meant to trick an applicant. They're really meant to see and get a feel for different aspects of the individual and get a sense of if they're the right fit for the program.
Mm-hmm. I know you don't want to share with me the questions for obvious reasons, but let me see if I can propose some potential behavioral
sure,
questions to
sure.
see if that gets a flavor for what you're talking about.
Uh-huh.
So would it be, you say to the applicant, suppose you found yourself in the following situation,
yes.
what would you do? you're on your way to the lab to deliver some blood that you drew, and you see a patient in the hall who looks confused.
Yes.
And then you say, well, what would you do?
That's
and,
a perfect question. Maybe okay. I should borrow
Oh, you should
that.
Steal it. Okay,
yeah,
that's
I think that's
fine.
Great.
except you can't use that one because everyone's now heard it. So. But it's based, and it's not, as you said, it's not a trick question.
No.
It's not like there's a secret answer.
Exactly.
There might be many possible correct answers, and you want to see how they deal with the situation.
Absolutely.
Okay. So what tips would you give someone who's about to go to their first interview?
I would say be yourself, mm-hmm. first and foremost. This is a place where you're going to spend 3 years. You're going to be very deeply interacting deeply with everybody. So it's very important to find a place that fits. And then also it's tremendously important to research the program, to look at the website, to see what kind of people go to this program, what is the program's mission, and also to think about why am I choosing this specialty, right? So that you can speak to the things that you care about in a way that is relatable and a way that is clear to all the people that you'll be meeting that day. It's also really great to practice a little bit, to meet with some people who can role play with you, or maybe even practice in the mirror and do a little practicing so that you feel more comfortable in the interview session, because it's daunting no matter who you are, no matter where it is.
Have you ever interviewed an applicant who seemed over rehearsed?
No, I don't think so. I've met a lot of applicants who are very nervous, who are a little shell-shocked, but not over-rehearsed. I think if the rehearsal is just being natural and answering questions, then I don't think you could ever be over-rehearsed. Mm-hmm. Certainly, you can memorize answers to questions, and that can be a put-off.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And have you ever gotten the sense that you're interviewing someone who's interviewed at 25 other programs already, and this is their last interview?
I believe that we get applicants who've interviewed at that many programs sometimes. And the only time that we have a sense of that is when the person's not engaged with us, mm-hmm. when, you know, they come late, they want to leave early, they're not as engaged when they're having lunch with the residents, things like that will be an alarming thing for us.
The info that you get from the interview, how does that feed into your ranking of candidates?
It's the most important aspect in terms of our ranking process. We do use a numeric system where we assign values to different things, such as our questions, and then we rank order everybody based on the numerical total that they achieve. But then, based on the interview, we may go ahead and tweak the list just a little bit. Because our personal interactions are really the most valuable.
Mm-hmm. So I want to clarify, are you saying that all the stuff in the application, once someone's come to the interview, that other stuff is almost unimportant for the rank list?
Yes, actually, because by the time people have interviewed, we've already vetted their academic standing. Mm-hmm. And so usually everybody who's come for an interview is academically capable of being a great resident. We do a little bit more probing into that area, but primarily the rest is interpersonal. And so, yes, once they've made it to the interview, everything else is not so important.
Any other final comments about the interviews?
I think it's an exciting time. It's very inspiring for programs and the program director to be in this process. We are just as nervous as the applicants, maybe not as much because we get to do it every year, but we are also trying to be on our best behavior, so it's really kind of like a dating game, and so hopefully that would help our applicants be a little bit less nervous as they start the process.